who needs another speaker brand? That is a good question, but I think we have the answer, because the PURIFI company has designed speaker drivers with very unique parameters, performance, which allows basically to make compact speakers with performance similar to larger speakers, with very, very low distortion and great frequency extension. My name is Peter Lyngdorf. To those who don't know me, I'm the founder of HiFi Klubben, DALI loudspeakers. A few years ago, I was co-founder of a new company called PURIFI, and PURIFI now designs Class D amplifiers and loudspeaker drivers.
Radiant Acoustics is a speaker brand where we aim to offer high-end sound quality at a real value for money price point. My name is Henrik Reinholdtsen, and I'm the CEO of Nordic HiFi, the company behind Radiant Acoustics. A couple of years ago, I had a conversation with Peter Lyngdorf about PURIFI, and especially why it was so difficult to buy real PURIFI speakers anywhere in the market, especially at affordable prices. And from that conversation, we just started, you know, talking, maybe we should just make it ourselves. PURIFI is one of Peter's companies, and so it sort of made sense, just do it ourselves. And as soon as I had that conversation, as soon as I said it to him, I could see that he started thinking, okay, how do we make these speakers stand out in the market?
Well, a typical customer we have in mind when we design these speakers is people who are really discerning music lovers, who appreciate the dynamic range of real live music and so on, in terms of having the transient capabilities in the bass, mid, highs and so on that is similar to what you experience in live music. But you still have a very compact size.
The ambitious goal we set out to do was to combine a subwoofer with an exquisite mid-range without letting the bass reproduction kill the mid-range. I'm Lars Risbo. I'm one of the co-founders of PURIFI, and we have designed the Ushinti woofers, and we also designed the very special waveguide for this project. I think it's a dream that has come true by having a project like this Radiant Acoustics project that offers such a performance actually at an affordable price. And Radiant Acoustics asked for not compromising anything. So it is a full-blown Ushinti woofers with all bells and whistles, and managed to do that in an affordable product. I think that's, for me personally, it's a joy that this can reach out to more people and they get the full package of all we work on for the last almost 10 years.
PURIFI has come up with speaker drivers that have much less distortion than other drivers. The woofers looks very peculiar. The surround looks different, but inside there are technologies that have never been seen before. And these technologies allow us to make speakers that are very compact, but with great bass extension and very low distortion. And these are expensive drivers. They are made in Denmark, and there are close to 30 different things that have been changed compared to conventional drivers.
And the problem with conventional long stroke drivers is that they simply change behavior as the woofer moves in and out. But also the long coil you need for a long stroke acts as an inductor. And as it moves, out of the gap and in of the gap, it actually changes its inductance. So it's a bit like having a crossover inductor that changes whether the mover is in and out. And that's obviously really not a good thing. So that's one of the very important things about the Vicinity woofers, is that inductance doesn't change with position. And interesting enough, that solves another problem that we have in woofers, is that when you have your audio current from your amplifier going through the voice coil, it creates its own magnetic field. And some of that magnetic field goes into the magnetic gap and actually changes the field you have there from your permanent magnet. If that happens, you have like a gain sensitivity change. And that's something that modulates all frequencies, including mid-range. Again, you have something where the bass can disrupt the mid-range that we want to avoid. And the interesting thing is, if you make inductance independent of position, you actually kill two birds with one stone.
We use one active, and then we use two passive drivers. The passive drivers have the same effect as a bass reflex port that is a normal thing to use in a loudspeaker. Of course, a bass reflex port is basically just a plastic tube in most cases, and it costs virtually nothing. But if you want to make a very compact speaker that goes very low in frequency, the port has to have a large diameter and be very long. So the cabinet ends up being much, much bigger. Using the passive radiator, we get two advantages. One is the cabinet is smaller, and the second is we don't have any port noise. Almost every small loudspeaker with a bass reflex port creates some noise from the port, also up into the mid-range. That does not happen with the passive radiators. This is a more costly way to do it. But the advantage of a smaller cabinet is also that the cabinet sides are smaller. You have less problems with standing waves and so on inside the cabinet. So there are advantages of using passive radiators in small speakers, especially when you use the PURIFI drivers, which, because of the high SPL available from the woofer, would create a lot of port noise because it can produce a lot of bass. Cabinets, everything is designed for low distortion. So when you have speaker drivers where we have dramatically reduced distortion, we also have to make better cabinets. We have to make better crossovers. We have also then manufactured an AMT tweeter, AMT air motion transformer tweeter. It is made by DALI for us, and it is a CNC machine, fully symmetrical, cost no object driver, which has much, much more output than a conventional dome tweeter. But that is further enhanced with the AMT combination with the waveguide. And the waveguide has been designed by Lars Risbo, one of the founding members of PURIFI, and he will talk separately about the mathematics about that. It doesn't look like any other waveguide, and is then combined with fins to increase the dispersion at high frequency. So it's a unique design, never really been done in a production speaker before.
The approach we use is heavily based on computer simulation. Around us we have optimization, computer-driven optimization. And that means that we over a night can run hundreds, maybe thousands of trial and error on the shape. And the optimization finds the best shape that meets the requirements we set up. The chances that you draw something freehand as an arc or a straight line or something, that it works. That's very small. So this is where the computer helps to find that correct shape. Then a very special thing we do on this waveguide is that we also do something in the top octave where all tweeters tend to be directional. And we avoid that by having what we call a coherer. So that's objects that help scatter the sound to spread it more evenly. In that way, we can do a constant directivity from the crossover of the to the woofer all the way up to 20 kilohertz. And that is, in our experience, very important for the perception of the sound.
On the objective measurements, I would say the main focus has actually been the directivity of the loudspeaker system and at the first point of the individual loudspeaker drivers in the complete system. And here we are talking about directivity in the horizontal plane as well as the vertical plane. My name is Jens Schönemann-Paul. I'm an acoustical engineer. My role in the Radiant Acoustics project is basically any part of the electroacoustical design. When talking about distortion in crossover, each component can add distortion. That's also the reason why we're using air coils in all positions to avoid the so-called current distortion. Capacitors and resistors has also been chosen carefully by objective measurements and evaluated by the listening evaluation to make sure that we had the optimum performance.
What I've been involved in primarily in this project is the concept and also designing the cabinet. I still have a woodworking shop at home, so I can make prototypes at home, and it's one of my hobbies. So when I design a cabinet, I have a good feel for how to design it so it doesn't have any naughty noises. There are already quite a few speaker manufacturers using the PURIFI woofers and mid-range drivers. We have tried to come with our best interpretation using the AMT waveguide so that we believe we get really exceptional performance out of the final product. So our customers will experience a speaker that has a wider dynamic range, much more detailed sound, but not only more detailed, but more quiet. So if you play something with a bass guitar and a female voice at the same time, the female voice is going to be totally clean and transparent, even when the speaker is also reproducing the bass. And that is something that other speakers have a really, really hard time doing if they are a small, compact speaker.
Radiant Acoustics has been a collaboration between a lot of Peter Lyngdorf's different companies. And that's something that we rarely do, but on this project, we've all worked together to make it as good as absolutely possible. So of course, Nordic HiFi has been the driving force behind the concept of the whole project, but we will also be, of course, selling these speakers direct to consumer, which is the key to keeping the price down and keeping them as affordable as possible. PURIFI has brought in a lot of innovation and really cool technology to make them sound as great as possible. And then, of course, we are doing the assembly and all of the logistics from HiFi Klubben's warehouse, which is where I'm at right now. And of course, HiFi Klubben will also be the go-to retail partner for this project. So you can go into your HiFi Klubben shop and get a real cool demonstration of these speakers. So seeing all of these companies coming together in this way has been such a really cool thing to witness. I think it's fair to say that no other company in the world could have made a speaker of this quality and then sell it at this price. It is a combination of Peter's company is having, I think, the most know-how in the world combined. When you combine all of the brilliant people employed in Peter's companies in the audio business, I don't think you will find any company in the world that has that level of know-how and experience.